A makeshift memorial has sprung up in downtown Orlando, providing friends and loved ones a place to grieve for those they lost in the tragic mass shooting at the Pulse nightclub. Mourners brought photos of the victims, as well as flowers, candles, signs such as this one that says World Peace. 27-year-old RJ Bataykan is a regular patron at Pulse nightclub. He says he may not know all the victims well, but he says he felt like he lost 49 of his closest friends.
Being part of LGBT community po kasi siguro parang I just want to be here, you know, for the people of Orlando. Parang nakakalungkot po talagang isipin na pwede po ito mangyari kahit kanino.
Another makeshift memorial is building up just a few blocks away from Pulse. Mary Chris Smith knew one of the fatalities, but she believes that the city of Orlando should not live in fear.
I think we should not live in fear. I mean, that's what they want us to feel is fear. We're mourning, but we should not live in fear just because they try to terrorize us.
President Obama has called for a ban on assault weapons. He says an AK-47, such as the one used by the nightclub shooter, should not be easily available.
Reinstate the assault weapons ban. Make it harder for terrorists to use these weapons to kill us.
These Filipino-Americans say they support Obama's call for an assault weapons ban.
There's no reason for anyone to have an assault rifle. A handgun for protection, that's fine, but to have something that has 30 bullets in one magazine, there's no reason to have that.
There needs to be more background checks that are being done to check who a gun is going to and what the intentions are.
The NRA has said gun control is not effective in stopping mass shooting, but Obama is expected to make the case against gun violence on Thursday as he visits and pays his respects to the victims of the Pulse nightclub massacre. Don Tagala, ABS-CBN News, Orlando, Florida.